Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today's video is a real-time watercolor painting with tips. And I also speed up part of the video to shorten the overall length, so you get the best of both worlds. You have the real-time and the speed painting. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to like it, leave a comment, and subscribe if you want to see more videos. Thanks for stopping by. Bye!
So I'm just using ultramarine blue at this point and burnt sienna. And right now I'm using my very old broken down synthetic brush to do some mixing. I don't want my really good brushes to be broken down by mixing my paints. So at this point, I use my really broken down brushes with their hairs falling out because that's how I mix. And I'm making a very watery mix right now, and that may change, but currently I'm doing a very watery mix of a dark brown. Let's get my picture pulled. This reference photo is from Karen. Artist reference photos by Karen. And this is her very beautiful paint horse. So this is my paint on paper. But really with this one, I'm just winging it. I don't know what I'm doing. I just started painting. And this one might be too small, but basically I paint like I'm holding a pencil. I don't know if that's right or wrong, but that's what I do. And after I get a little bit of water down or paint down, and then I come back through and I put a little bit of water on my brush and I just very gently blend it out so I have no hard lines, because I don't want hard lines. So at this point, I'm just laying in some more darks. And some of the darks, I do want hard lines. And then I do have hard lines. Look around the cheek here. I want some really hard lines here. Good thing it stayed off the paper. All right. Dropped my brush. Not a good thing. You must always match the direction of the fur. If you don't, your animal will not look realistic. And right now I'm just laying down kind of the base layers. And like I said, I really don't know what I'm doing. I just decided to jump in and start doing. So now I'm just trying to build up some of my layers that I see. Build up the darks. Get the layers the way I want them. One thing I have a really hard time on is I really don't go dark enough. I have a real hard time with that. one-offs. A lot of artists have that issue, but I sure have that issue. I just don't go dark enough. So with this painting and with another one that I'm doing in colored pencil, I'm really, really pushing myself to go dark. Oh, and these are Winsor & Newton professional watercolors. So even when I'm kind of laying in my colors, I'm still going in the direction of the fur. Even when I put my base layers down, I'm still going in the direction of the fur. Because if you don't, you don't catch the subtleties of the muscles and the contrasting colors and all of that. You lose out on all of this detail that really you don't even have to put in if you put your layers in the direction of the fur. Yeah, currently I'm doing this with not being live, but I hope to have live feed before long. I'm working on getting my cameras and stuff set up. At this point I'm recording this on my iPad. My iPad Pro is being my camera right now. This is like a white patch on the horse's bum. That I kind of messed up. That's one thing, when you're trying to do a realistic, you gotta get things where they're supposed to be, or you kinda mess things up. And here I'm just dabbing off a little bit of the color that I, like I said, I kinda missed some light area that was on the horse. And let's do a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of green. And I'm doing a sage green. So I'm adding a little bit of ultramarine to my sage green. And I'm just going to darken some of the colors right in here. So I have the look of what I'm attempting here, and that is foliage out of focus. But like I said, I really don't know what I'm doing. I just play, and it seems to come out pretty good. This whole background was really fun to do. I just started dropping paint down and creating what I was doing. I got a little bit of darkness going on right in here. It goes out. And I'm loosely following this photograph because I find I just don't follow the reference photos quite as much as maybe I should, but this is not a commission, so this is just a learning experience for me. So as such, I just do my own thing and I see what happens. And one thing I apply in my watercolors is color theory. I'm applying those to any medium I pick up. And they work. Because color theory is color theory. It is to anything you try to use it in. your blues and your greens, the cold colors recede and your warm colors come forward. So as you can see, I'm putting a lot of blue and green back here in this part of the background because I'm trying to bring my horse forward. So popping him out of the page here. Well, attempting to anyways. I don't know if I'm succeeding. You guys will have to tell me that. People that are a little more familiar with it than I am. And as you can tell, I'm just sitting here and I dampen my brush a little bit and I soften my edges because this is a background and it doesn't need to be in focus. And then I step back and I look at it. And I'm not so sure this view is the greatest view for you guys to see, but it works. Like I said, I need to get my camera set up. All right, let's go back to the horse. As you can see, I bounce all over the place because that is the nature of watercolor. I do not touch a spot that is wet because that'll run the paint down into where you don't want it to be. But I am still learning. That is for sure. I will be the first to admit that. I am still learning. And who knows, maybe what I'm doing is wrong in a normal application. But it works for me. And I like the results. And I guess that's all that matters. It's just I'm honing my techniques. Learning, teaching myself, honing my techniques. Kind of got into the horse's butt there a little bit. But I also find correcting your errors is pretty darn easy with watercolors. And here I'm going to actually drop in some wet on water and see what happens. Because this is always fun. You just get a lot of paint, you plop it in, and you watch it as it expands. Ooh, that was a lot of green I just slapped in there. Tone it down a little bit with the blue. And drop it in while it's still wet. And you create interest, but not too much, because we are trying to bring the horse forward. We're not trying to lose the viewer's attention in the background, into the background. We don't want the viewer spending a lot of time back in the background. We just want him to look at it and say, oh yeah, isn't this cool? Also try to lead the viewer back to the horse. I seem to have lost something right in here. So let's see. I don't know. Since I'm not really looking too much at the reference photo to do all of this, this is kind of just coming out of however it happens, which is always fun. Kind of makes it different and definitely makes it unique. It's not the reference photo. I like to take a reference photo and I like to create a painterly representation of the reference photo. But I want this horse to just pop out. So that's kind of what I'm on process right now. Oops, I still got almost too much water there. Trying to add some more blues into this very vibrant green and take it into the background. Part of it I want to keep in the foreground, but part of it I want in the background. Like I said, I'm a beginner. I don't really know a whole lot. But I'm hoping what I'm sharing will help another beginner. But maybe some of my experiences will help them out. Some of my trial and errors that I suffer from sometimes. And I've actually thought about taking this and adding a little bit of color pencil to it to take it maybe a little bit further than my paints are taking it. But I'm just not sure. I don't know. Just not sure where I want to go with this yet. So we got the point here. Then we got the muscle here. And then we got more darkness back in here. One thing you gotta be very, very careful with watercolor is you put your paint down, and as long as your paper is wet, you can keep on dabbing along and making corrections and whatnot. But if your water is dry on your paper, stop. Let it, if it starts drying out, just stop. Let it dry out completely. Then go back in and make your corrections. And that one I definitely learned the hard way. Because you just want to keep on putzing with it. And you can actually start tearing your paper. And it just doesn't look very good. So if it starts drying out, just stop. Go to another spot, let it dry out. Let it dry out completely. Before you touch it again. But to make it flow, I try to lose the hard edges, except where I want hard edges. All right, Alright, so the belly, these hairs come down. This is outside of the flank. So, I am really starting to like that background. Unfortunately, you really can't see it, so let's try to get this camera to see it. There, can you see it now? I hope so. This is a pretty long recording, so I think I'm going to sign it off now. And